Assalamu alaikum to all SBR students. A very warm welcome to our podcast series, the Student Exam Support Series by HusseinQazi.com. Empowering minds is our mission. Disclaimer, all the material of this podcast is compiled with tech support from HusseinQazi.com. Sustainable development and reporting. To gain exam confidence in the topic of sustainable related standards, IFRS S1 and IFRS S2, you should thoroughly listen to the series of two podcasts and read the attached relevant material. You can find the document containing the description part of this video. Let's start the podcast. Welcome to Sustainability Matters, the podcast that explores the latest developments in sustainability reporting. As per Hussein Koz's recommendation in today's episode, the content will be covered in this sequence. First, to understand the concept of sustainable development. Second, the concept of sustainable reporting. Third, sustainable reporting standards, IFRS S1 and IFRS S2. Students, make sure you have subscribed to my YouTube channel before moving forward. Come on. Let's set the stage by understanding what sustainable development really means. Aha! First, sustainable development. In essence, sustainable development is about meeting the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their own needs. It's about finding a balance between economic growth, social development, and environmental protection. Imagine a world where thriving economies coexist with healthy ecosystems, where everyone has access to basic necessities and opportunities. That's the vision of sustainable development. And to make that vision a reality, we need transparency and accountability. That's where sustainable reporting comes in. Yes, you listen very right statement. Second, sustainable reporting. The transparent reporting need for sustainable reporting. It's the practice where organizations publicly disclose their economic, environmental, and social impacts. It's like a company's sustainability report card, telling us not just about their profits, but also about their impact on the planet and society. Sustainability reporting has two main focuses. One is understanding impacts. This is about looking at how a company affects society and the environment. It includes things like environmental performance, emissions, waste management, etc. Social performance, labor practices, community engagement, etc. Economic performance, impact on local communities. Second is enterprise value. This is about seeing how social and environmental factors can affect a company's worth. It's about understanding risks, climate change, resource scarcity, etc. Opportunities, cost savings from sustainability, improved reputation, etc. Wow! In short, sustainability reporting is about understanding a company's full impact and how that affects its value. Let's take a quick example. Imagine a sustainable textile manufacturer. They are using innovative dyeing techniques to reduce water consumption, sourcing organic cotton, and recycling waste materials. They are also ensuring fair labor practices and supporting community development projects. All of these actions have a positive impact on both society and the environment. But they also create value for the company itself. Their commitment to sustainability enhances their brand reputation, attracts eco-conscious consumers, and can even lead to cost savings in the long run. All the story cut short. Sustainable development means finding a way for everyone to live well now and in the future, without harming the planet. To help with this, we have new rules called IFRS S1 and S2. These rules make companies tell us more about how they affect the environment and society. This helps investors make better choices and encourages companies to be more responsible. In the end, these rules are like a guide to help create a better world for all of us. With this episode of Sustainable Standard, Hussein Qazi recommendation only to cover IFRS S1. IFRS S1 objective. Let's start with the basics. The core objective of IFRS S1 is to ensure companies provide transparent and useful information about their sustainability practices. This empowers investors and other stakeholders to make informed decisions about the company's long-term prospects. Essentially, it's about connecting financial performance with sustainability impact. Core insights. We're diving deep into the world of sustainability reporting with IFRS S1, the new standard that's changing the game for how companies disclose their sustainability-related risks and opportunities. Yes. The core points: sustainability-related risk and opportunities. Whether you're an investor, a company executive, or simply someone who cares about the planet, understanding IFRS S1 is crucial in today's business landscape. Ice-breaking examples, extracted by Hussein Qazi. Example 1, the manufacturing giant. Imagine a large manufacturing company operating in an area prone to extreme weather events. Under IFRS S1, they'd have to disclose the potential risks of climate change. Think supply chain disruptions, higher insurance costs, and the financial impact of complying with new environmental regulations. This helps investors gauge the company's resilience in the face of climate challenges. Example 2, the fashion brand under fire. Now consider a well-known fashion brand facing criticism for using child labor and unsustainable sourcing practices. IFRS S1 mandates that they disclose the potential financial risks associated with these practices. This could include reputational damage, consumer boycotts, and hefty fines. Investors can then assess the impact of these issues on the company's bottom line and future sustainability. Let's bring this to life with a couple of examples. IFRS S1 disclosure content. So, what exactly do companies need to disclose under IFRS S1? There are four core areas of content. Governance. Who's in charge of sustainability within the company? What processes are in place to manage sustainability-related risks and opportunities? Strategy. What's the company's overall approach to sustainability? How do their sustainability goals fit into their broader business strategy? Risk management. How does the company identify, assess, and monitor sustainability risks and opportunities? Metrics and targets. How is the company performing in relation to its sustainability goals? Are they on track to meet their targets? By providing information in these areas, companies create transparency about their sustainability efforts. This helps investors make more informed decisions about where to allocate their resources. Practical example, extracted by Hussein Qazi. Solar energy company. Let's take a look at how this works in practice with a fictional solar energy company called SolarTech. Sustainability risks and opportunities. Risks. Supply chain disruptions, regulatory changes, and fierce competition. Opportunities. Government subsidies and incentives, growing consumer demand, and technological advancements. IFRS S1 disclosures. Governance. SolarTech has a sustainability committee overseeing its strategy and initiatives. Strategy. The company's strategy is aligned with global climate goals, focusing on market expansion and innovative solar solutions. Risk management. A robust framework is in place to identify and mitigate potential risks. Metrics and targets. The company tracks KPIs like renewable energy capacity and greenhouse gas emissions reduction. It sets ambitious targets in line with industry benchmarks and sustainability goals. By disclosing this information under IFRS S1, SolarTech gives investors a clearer picture of its sustainability performance and long-term prospects. Conclusion. IFRS S1 is a game changer in the world of sustainability reporting. It's about ensuring companies are transparent about their sustainability practices and empowering investors to make informed decisions. Whether you're a business leader, an investor, or simply someone who cares about the planet, understanding IFRS S1 is essential in today's world. Thank you for tuning in. Until next time, keep sustainability at the forefront of your business practices. With this episode, we covered the background and need of sustainable reporting and also main IFRS 1 core understanding. Hussein Koz's high recommendation to read the attached document to cover more details. 1. IFRS 1 and beyond. 2. Similarities between IFRS sustainability and accounting standards. 3. IFRS 1 and conceptual framework. 4. IFRS general requirements and very important. 5. Other sustainable reporting frameworks like GRI, SASB, TCFD, and more. In the next episode, we'll delve into the specifics of IFRS S2, focusing on climate-related disclosures. Until then, stay tuned to Sustainability Matters. Thank you for your time. Remember these wise words, and indeed the hereafter is better for you than the present, life. Al-Quran. Best of luck for your exams. Get more valuable insights by staying connected with HusseinKozzi.com. Empowering minds is our mission. Thanks you very much.